Hey guys, welcome back to Walk and Talk Music Reactions with John. I'm John. I'm out walking. I'm talking. I'll be reacting in just a minute. Now, just so you know, my little selfie stick thingy here, it's being wonky. So if you go flip-flopping around, just so you know, it's that. It's not me trying to be tricky with the camera, going for some new effect or whatever. So it's about 95, 96 degrees right now. Just tried to do a couple of little quick live things. I went on this one and it's good to see Concert Buddy popped up. Then I went live on my other channel, my Music Talk with John. I got about 5 or 6 people and that was kind of cool. So I think about maybe, because on Mondays I try to film these and I have some time. So I might start doing some lives on Mondays around, I don't know, 2 o'clock Eastern time. So anyway, let's get into this. You guys want all that stuff, but I might start doing some, keep an eye out on Mondays around, like I said, 2 o'clock, 2:30, somewhere in that area, Eastern time. And I might just pop up live. And if you guys are around, pop up and say hello and be kind of cool to interact with you in that kind of fashion. So let's see what we have today and who brought it to us. All right, so we have a song by Nick Lowe. This is Cruel to Be Kind from the Labor of Lust album, 1979, and it's brought to you by Don Moore. Hello, Don. Don has been with me for a while and brought me a lot of cool songs, especially that Elvis Costello stuff. I'm digging that. So, did you know? Cruel to Be Kind remains Nick Lowe's only single to hit the top 40 in the U.S. I guess he had a lot more success in the U.K. That's all he, that's his biggest hit in the U.S. And it is inspired by The Love I Lost by Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. And I'm going to bring this up because I read that. I'm like, let me just do a quick little research and a little sample to see what was the inspiration for this song. So here's the album. And I actually had this album. I can't remember how I got it. If it was in like a box of records somebody gave me, or I know it's in something somebody gave me. And I had it and I liked it, but it was in just bad shape. So I ended up getting rid of it. So, and while we're talking, we're getting an Amber Alert. Great. Palm Beach, Florida. Okay, I hear you, Amber Alert. Okay. So, all right. So I had this album, it was in rough shape, so I ended up getting rid of it. But I might end up picking it up again. It's sort of has a 70s, has a lot of orchestration, so it has sort of a disco feel. But the voices are so, the lead singer, I don't know, I guess that's Harold Melvin. And I know Teddy Pendergrass is part of this band. But Harold Melvin, if that's the guy, I'm assuming, who's singing, because I don't know much about these guys, so forgive me, and my knowledge isn't great on this, but what a nice voice, and just nice tone. So this is, I'm going to play you a little clip here. This gives you an idea of what this Nick Lowe song was inspired by. So let's see real quick. Let's see Harold Melvin here. Okay, so that's kind of like the chorus part of the song or something. And so that feel is what we're looking for. That sounds like a kind of a disco sound, right? Feel, but with like a four tops voices over top is how I'm hearing that part of that song. So anyway, that's what the song was inspired by, supposedly. So yeah, inspired by The Love I Lost. What's the song about? The deceptively cheery song, Cruel to Be Kind, is about a lover and at his wit's end because of his companion's blatant disregard for his feelings. So I'll have to pay attention to the lyrics. Sorry, I'm kind of like choppy in my reading, but it's dark with these on. And I've explained to you I got to keep them on or I get headaches and all that fun stuff. And then it's small, so maybe I need to come in. Anyway, songs from the same year, which is 1979, Ring My Bell by Anita Ward, The Logical Song by Supertramp, love it, love that album, Breakfast in America, no, yeah, that was on Breakfast in America, and Highway to Hell by AC/DC. What a variety of music, right? So let's bring it up and let's see what Nick Lowe has to offer. Okay, I can hear that Harold, the Melvin deal there, in there, Harold Melvin, right? Yeah, Harold Melvin. I can hear that in there, definitely, that the drive, part of the melody, but I can hear where he got inspired, definitely. It has like a 60s feel, right? Like a doo-wop almost feel to it. Very retro, I guess, of 79, but it had been retro for the time. So yeah, and I like it. It's a cool melody, good pop sense to it. I like that, a good catchy lyric. I mean, not lyric, but a melody. I was trying to listen to lyrics, but I wasn't really catching it, what she was doing to be cruel, to be kind. I understand that's what she's telling him, so I'll try to pay better attention to the lyrics here. But I was caught up in all the other sounds going on. I wasn't paying attention to lyrics. So, part two's already up, so let's finish it up. It's a short song, I guess. Okay, so it's a guy saying, I'm doing all these things for you to show you my love, and you know, you're not being nice to me. And he's asking for an explanation. She's like, it'd be cruel to be kind. So kind of a twisted little song there, you know. In other words, she's not into it. And she's saying, that's just love, baby. That's just how it goes. So yeah, great song. I like that song. It's a good song. You should check out this whole album if the rest of his stuff is like this. Oh, a little alligator came up. So yeah, very good song. Thank you, Dawn. I like that. I'm glad you brought that to my attention. And I've heard the name Nick Lowe before, but really never, I don't think I've really checked out much of his stuff. So I'm glad you did. So tell me what you guys think in the comments below. And I want to point something out real quick that I just noticed while I'm over here, besides listening to a little Mr. Gator guy. But if you've seen my previous video where I'm hanging out over here, I hope you can still hear me. But I'm always like, oh, look, and there's Mr. Gator guy. See him? And Mr. Gator. Chill, not coming my way, so nobody's feeding them, which is good. But if you look right over here, see that right there? Everyone's always like, oh, look at the cool little goose or duck or whatever that is. Yeah, I just realized, you guys can hear me. That's fake. That's a decoy of some sort. Can I zoom in on it? Yeah, it does let me zoom in. Look at that. It's not even real. So all the time I've been out here, just never really paid close enough attention to go. That thing never moves. It's always in the same spot. Yeah, it's not real. So, there you go. That's how observant I am. So, let me switch you back around.
And there we go. Let me finish the video up. Okay, kind of went off screen. Sorry if that messed up there. So, yeah, that's great. I've been checking out a goose duck thing back there that's not even real. So, there you go. That shows you how concentrated I am on this music, you know. I could be in danger, and I do that for you guys, to do these songs. See what I do? I put myself in danger. I could fall into a lake. I could trip over a tree. I could get eaten by an alligator that's like 2 inches long. So there you go. Anyway, leave comments down below. Let me know what you thought of the song. More song suggestions would be awesome. Let me know what you guys think and all that fun stuff, and I hope you guys are doing well. And until next time, hope you enjoy your music. And you take care out there, all right? Bye.